think it's important to have the Puerto Rico Puerto Rican summits and conferences because it informs the community and talk about solutions that are needed and are happening to provide resources for the different issues that we engage with.
It is a pleasure to welcome you to the Puerto Rico Puerto Rican New England Summit in the great city of Hollywood, where you can find some of the best Puerto Rican food in this area.
I'm extremely excited to the historical moment for all of us residing in New England and beyond. This summit will allow us to come together as a community and as a people to have an in-depth understanding on the fiscal and humanitarian crisis taking place in Puerto Rico. Let's attempt to use this time together today to fully engage, network, and learn from one another in order to create the solutions that are necessary. Today we will hear what many are already doing stateside to give la bienvenida and putting supports in place so that the transition from living on the island to stateside is not as difficult as it was for those that came before us.
Es importante tener esta conferencia porque es importante poder levantar conciencia en la comunidad puertorriqueña, la diáspora puertorriqueña, de dónde es que estamos, cuál es la situación de Puerto Rico y cómo nosotros como puertorriqueños en los Estados Unidos podemos influenciar esa situación para mejorarla.
The Puerto Rican crisis is a complex problem that has evolved over many years and it's not easy to understand. So conferences like this bring some clarity and information about what's going on.
I should know more about Puerto Rico and the crisis and what's going on, and this is the opportunity to come and learn something that I think is valuable.
Yo creo que estas conferencias son oportunidades donde líderes y personas que están haciendo trabajo por Puerto Rico o por comunidades puertorriqueñas en la diáspora tienen un espacio en común para compartir ideas, intercambiar, conocerse y ver de qué manera pueden colaborar.
Hay tantos temas que tratar y como hemos hablado, la llegada de muchas familias puertorriqueñas a esta área requiere que haya una respuesta organizada, una manera de lidiar con los retos de esas familias, sea en lo que sea, en la educación, en servicios públicos, servicios sociales, vivienda, etc.
Important for the Puerto Rican community to organize and mobilize. More than ever, we have an untapped political power that we should get going.
Every state where we have a footprint of Puerto Ricans is growing in population. Every state.
Earlier today, through Dr. Melendez's presentation, he highlighted the growing number of Puerto Ricans in Connecticut, Massachusetts, Rhode Island.
The only period in our history that compares to what we're undergoing now is back in the 50s, when the first wave of migration of Puerto Ricans migrants came to the U.S.
That number will only continue to increase with the current economic crisis on the island. So with that and the political power that Puerto Ricans have within New England through elected positions, it's fitting that it's here in Massachusetts. It's fitting that it's here in Holyoke.
Our population today is around 40,000 people. 47% of our city is Latino, mostly of Puerto Rican descent. And so when we're talking about progress in the public schools or housing development, we're seriously talking about the future and success of the Puerto Rican community here in the city of Holyoke.
Puerto Ricans have been coming to New England for decades now. There's a vast Puerto Rican population that would benefit from learning about ways to organize and to organize politically to get things going for the community. And at the same time, those of us who are not from here, we can learn about local leaders.
Es que la comunidad puertorriqueña de los Estados Unidos está regada, estamos muy dispersos. Entonces esto nos provee un espacio para llegar juntos como comunidad, conocernos, entender cuáles son los problemas y entonces empezar organizándonos para crear acción. El primer punto de acción es unirnos.
It is time for we as a community to come together to organize, to mobilize, and to ensure that the community at large knows that Puerto Ricans are here and we are here to stay, and that we're going to unite for Puerto Rico and the issues that are impacting our community.
Así que un día como hoy es bien importante, no solamente para crear y levantar esa conciencia, pero también para tener ese llamado a la acción que nos ayude a crear un cambio positivo para la isla.
These conferences bring together Puerto Ricans from different parts of the United States and ties them to their Puerto Rican brethren on the island, so that then Puerto Rico is not just a place where you go to the beach, but actually a place that has issues, a place that has potential for growth, and a place that is more complex than we give it credit for.
Para mí ser puertorriqueño significa tener orgullo de donde uno es.
Y siendo puertorriqueño, igual que americano en esta cultura acá, me siento orgulloso de que tengo voz y voto en los asuntos que se tratan de desarrollo económico o desarrollo o educación, etc.
Esos networks que se están creando, que yo estoy creando aquí, que creo con otras amistades, que vienen de Miami, de Chicago, de Connecticut, de diferentes áreas, fortalecen la comunidad puertorriqueña aún más y fortalecen las posibilidades de consenso político, cómo nos organizamos políticamente. Así que del centro no estar haciendo estas conferencias, tuviéramos una posición mucho más difícil a la hora de querer organizarnos como comunidad.
I really like when I heard the word nomadic, which I heard today a few times, to describe Puerto Rican, because I think that's who we are. We do what we need to do, we go where we need to go, so we can take care of our families.
Centro is playing a critical role in the movement beyond just New York, you know, and New Yorkans. This is not just New Yorkans anymore.
One of the things that El Centro has, it has the academic gravitas and authority to bring people from different sectors together in a way that other organizations could not. I'm very grateful for Centro because it has facilitated my involvement with the diaspora and my ability to take action.
And building from what we've done today and keep it going, you know, not just a one-step kind of thing, making sure that we keep this going, we keep conferences going, we keep bringing awareness to what's going on, not only to like the academics, but people in the community, you know, opening up spaces so people in Holyoke who don't really have the opportunity to go to a college or a university or go to New York City and learn about what's going on can come to their high school that's like 2-3 blocks away and they can learn what's going on.